When you see an illuminated form, it's actually the shadows that are helping your brain decipher the three-dimensional shape. So getting the shadows right in a painting is one of the most important secrets to rendering the form. In this video, I'll discuss hard and soft shadow edges and how to paint them in Photoshop. But as a quick reminder, if you look below the post, you'll find links for free brushes and worksheets, as well as in-depth premium series available in the Ctrl+Paint store. The example that I'm using here is a Greek statue, but this theory can be applied to any sort of form at all. So let's begin by taking a look at the shadow under her cheek line. You can see here that it starts with a smooth, soft transition from the light into the shadow, and then as her cheek turns and recedes into space, it gets darker and darker. Finally, at the bottom, there's this harsh transition between the darkest part of the shadow and the illuminated neck. And this is a crisp edge of a cast shadow. So at the top, there's a form shadow, which begins soft and gets darker and darker. And then it ends with a cast shadow, which is hard. So when it comes time to paint this shape of value, you've got two things. You've got a soft edge and a hard edge. So which type of brush do you use? Well, I like to actually use a soft brush. So here I'll paint underneath the tracing I've made, and I'll select a simple shadow value. And I'll start painting with a big, soft, round brush, getting darker and darker as it recedes down the cheek. But then I want that sharp, cast shadow edge. And since the soft, round brush won't work for this, I'm going to switch to the eraser tool with a hard, round eraser and carve back out that cast shadow edge. You could also use a mask for this if you wanted. That could give you a little more control. So there you see I've given the shadow its two basic components, the soft form shadow where it begins and the hard cast shadow where it ends. So here I'll take the same principle and zoom in a little bit more and do the eyeball. So I'll begin by the shadow cast by the brow ridge. It starts with a soft form shadow at the top, gets darker and darker as it goes deeper into the eye cavity, and then it ends with a sharp cast shadow. So I'll use the hard eraser and erase out that bottom bit. And then to protect this, I'll make a new layer, and then I'll do the eyelid. So it wells up underneath this fold of skin and then has a hard edge for the eyelid. And you can continue in this manner, making a new layer, putting in the soft edge, and then erasing out the hard edge, and render your entire form this way. So I've jumped ahead a bit here and finished out the drawing. But you can see the same principle applies to big and small forms. So let's look at the shadow cast by the nose. You can see it starts with a soft form shadow and ends with that hard cast shadow. And the same principle applies over and over. The upper lip, the lower lip, the cheek, it's everywhere. And if you start looking at photographs and objects around you, you'll see this all the time. Starts soft, ends hard. I found that looking at shadows in this way really helps me analyze the form and has really improved my observational drawing. So next time you guys are doing some photo studies and trying to draw from careful observation, make sure to look at the hard and soft edges of shadows.